Get ready to match the stars. Edward Asner, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, and Patty Doyle as we play in the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rivers.
Say hello to the lovely people over here. Hello, lovely people.
Hi, Bruno.
Lovely person.
Ask me what time it is.
What time is it?
Oh, I'll have to check. Wait a minute now.
Oh,
that's beautiful.
Oh, a Christmas present.
No.
You have a lovely head, Gene.
Oh, there it is. It's
Mickey's one hand is on the two.
11 minutes after two.
Who gave you the watch?
Well, the watch is from my father, and this beautiful little bauble here. It's a beautiful old English antique that he gave me two Christmases ago.
What's he showing?
I want it back.
Oh, no, you don't. It's 11 after 2, in case you're interested. Let's say hello to our current champ, George Frederick. George has won a bundle of money. He's got $15,900. He's won more games than anyone who's ever been on this program. He's won 11 games. And we're going to start with the audience match. Are you ready for it again?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, and don't move now. We'll give you a chance to catch your breath while we do a little business with America. Then we'll see if he wins more money. Hurry back. Here we go with old George. For the 11th time, he's up here. George, you got $15,900. We're going to see how much more money you can win now. Let's begin. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank Bears, B-E-A-R-S, Blank Bears. Now, $500, if you match the answer that audience gave most frequently, $250 for their second most popular answer, and $100 for the third answer on that list. Now, whom do you call on?
Charles?
Charles who?
Charles Nelson Reilly.
That's it. Speak up. Charles Nelson Reilly.
Well, one name for one of the Bears. Charles Nelson and Reilly. Three Bears.
Three Bears.
Aww. Try to keep it down to a rally, please.
Brett?
Well, you know, I'm a very big sports fan. That wonderful baseball team, the Chicago Bears.
The Chicago Bears. Terrific. Baseball team, of course. Papa Bear will be very, Hallis will be very unhappy with you. What do you say?
And Richard.
Richard.
Oh, the Milwaukee Bear. No.
Milwaukee Bears.
Grizzly Bears.
Grizzly Bears. Yes. So you got Grizzly Bears, Chicago Bears, and the Three Bears. Which one do you want, if any? Want one of your own?
I'll say Grizzly Bears.
What?
Grizzly Bears.
George.
Why do you say Grizzly Bears?
Well, I didn't say what Richard said last time. He said the $500
response. But you asked me first the last time.
But you know the thing. The third position is a little tougher to come up
with.
Don't
argue with him. He's making history on this show. He has his own cool way.
Okay. Won't we all be chagrined when Grizzly Bears turns out to be the winner up there on top? Let's find out right now. We're looking for Grizzly Bear. May we see the $100 response? Bad News Bears. That's a movie. With Walter Matthau, right? Now let's see the $250 number. Chicago Bears, there's Brett's answer. All right. I tell you, if it
George,
comes up Grizzly guy, I don't believe
George.
This. You don't think it's going to happen? What do you say, audience? Teddy Bears. Oh.
Three.
All right, may
three
we see
bears.
It, please?
Three bears.
All right. Well, listen, you picked up an additional $100 for winning the game. You're up to $15,900. You're going to meet another player now. Let's welcome Gayla Lisitra.
Hello there. Okay. Hello, Gayla.
Hi.
Gayla Lisitra. That's a very pretty name. What is that?
Thank you. It's Italian.
It's Italian. Lisitra. Bella ragazza questa, eh? What do you say?
Okay. Bella, bella.
Gayla, where are you from?
I live in Seattle, Washington.
Yep.
And I have two beautiful children. I'm very happily married.
Good. Uh-huh. What brings you to Los Angeles?
I'm drying out. It's very cold and wet up in Seattle, and I'm visiting my family for Christmas.
Oh, that's nice. You frightened me for a minute when you said you're drying out. I thought thought you had the
Never
same trouble.
Never frightened you when I say it.
Okay, here we go, Gayla. It's up to you for a choice here.
A.
A. Gayla. Gayla. Ready?
Mm.
Here it is. Santa Claus said, ho, 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 he, ho, 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 ho.
You're not crazy.
You all know I have a list of who's naughty and who's nice? Ho, 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 ho. Well, my nice list I made up myself, but I got my list of who's naughty from blank. I got my list, Santa said, I got my list of who's naughty from blank.
Next
makes up
question.
A nice list himself. Naughty list he gets from blank.
Oh, I know the answer to that one, Jack.
You've taken your shoes off.
Oh, nothing is sacred.
Are you uncomfortable?
No, you know, you can take the girl out of the South, but not
Would
the South
Would you like to see something in a sneaker? I mean, we have this model also in black suede. And in tan alligator. All right, let's go, Charles. He's writing, Gail. Gayla. Santa Claus says, ho, 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 ho. You all know I have a list of who's naughty and who's nice. Well, my nice list I made up myself. But I got my list of who's naughty from...
Rona Barrett.
Little Italian lady, very smart. Come up with nice answer. Rona Barrett, she said. Gossip type lady. What do you say?
Well, I was more or less down that same alley. Ho, ho, ho.
Ho.
And he gets his naughty list from The Inquirer.
The Inquirer. The gossip newspaper. Okay, where?
No? I have the definitive answer for this question. And I believe that everyone will agree. Richard Dawson's address book.
Say to that.
I wish it were true.
It's true enough, all right. I do not answer Santa Claus questions. Oh, that's because this recent past.
Say why it's because.
Just tell.
A year ago, we let him play Santa Claus. Every year for 2 years. And he's dressed up in a Santa Claus thing. You know,
yes.
It was a pretend thing. And he was a good... And he did all the questions as Santa Claus would answer.
It was adorable.
It was adorable. Yes. You were wonderful.
I said the Wicked Witch of the North.
The Wicked Witch. But I got one who's done it from the Wicked Witch of the North.
Oh,
that's a good answer.
North.
That's not bad at all. Hello, Marianne.
Hello.
The Shoeless Wonder. That was Joe Jackson, a famous baseball player. The Shoeless Wonder. The Shoeless Wonder. Yes. What do you say?
You've heard the expression, the devil made me do it?
The devil. That's good. Now, that
means
easy.
No boo, no applause.
You got another punch. Yeah. What do you say to this? I got my
Rona
list.
Rona is an excellent answer. I do not have that.
You don't have Rona Barrett?
You made the list there of the nice people.
I have my nice list I made myself, but I got my list of who's naughty from...
The FBI.
The FBI. What do they know? Hello, neat lady.
Yellow. I said he got the naughty list from the former H.R. Haldeman.
I like that one. So, Gayla, that's the way it goes. You lose some, and you lose some. Now, George, you'll be up in a moment or so, but right now we've got this for you, and then come back.
Able to help.
Here we go. Ready, George?
Ready.
Here it is. Another game. George Jessel said...
What? Oh, God help us.
Madam, you ought to be ashamed of yourself. Speaking out of turn that way. George Jessel said, yesterday I presided over a funeral, and it was terrible. In the middle of my eulogy, the guy in the coffin blanked. That's what George Jessel said. Yesterday I presided over a funeral, and it was terrible. In the middle of my eulogy, the guy in the coffin blanked.
My
mother's eyes. My. Oh. Oh, it hurts. Okay. Let's go, Ed. Ed, I'm going to cancel your new series. Guy like you's got your own show? Couldn't even write one word already? Okay, here we go. Now, George Frederick. George Jessel said, yesterday, I presided over a funeral and it was terrible. In the middle of my eulogy, the guy in the coffin blanked.
He booed.
He booed. He booed. What'd you say, Ed, finally?
Well,
boo. Oh. I should. Yeah. But anyway, I'm in the same vein as George. George.
Negative
the
expression.
The corpse delicious walked.
Good. One possibility. He was so bored, he got up and walked. What do you say?
I said he was so bored, he got up and he nodded off.
He nodded off. He'd already been nodded. Charles?
Joining the answers of distinguished players throughout the country. Yawn!
Yawn is a good one. Now, yawn is what I would have said if
yeah,
I had
that's
been
playing. Is that what makes it good? Is that what makes it good?
Yes.
Who does made you the judge?
Yeah. All right, Marianne, what do you say? Looking for the answer, booed.
You would have said yawn.
I would have said yawn.
Well, I thought the eulogy was so boring
that
he snored.
Snored is good. These are all good.
Right in the middle of my eulogy, he booed.
Now, let's see your answer.
He said he fell asleep.
He fell asleep. He was faking it. Well, you got one out of that.
Boy, you're
really leading a charmed life here. Okay, round two coming up. Gayla.
A.
A. She thought it over and wants A. Let's see what it says here. Ralph said.
Oh, dear.
My new alligator shoes require a lot of attention. Twice a day, I have to blank them. My new alligator shoes require a lot of attention. Twice a day, I have to blank them.
Is that the second round question?
That is the second round question.
So there has to be a regular
yes.
answer.
Oh, there's one marvelous answer.
Alligators. Let me look at. Sometimes I'm better.
I'll never show you.
Ralph said, my new alligator.
Oh, yeah.
No, you won't. No, come on. No, come on. Not on your life. You give me the bauble hanging from your back.
He's not going to show his answer. All right, you ready? Twice a day I have to blank them. Okay. All right, Gayla, did you think about it? I'll read it to you one more time. Ralph said, my new alligator shoes require a lot of attention. Twice a day, I have to blank them.
Bite.
What?
Bite.
Bite them. You have seen this program. I mean, this is not The Price is Right, you understand. That. Twice a day, I have to bite them, she says. I don't understand that answer.
Well... That's pressure. It's all due to pressure.
It's pressure.
Know? Yeah.
She's nervous.
Now, he bought some undead alligator shoes, so he had to feed them.
Feed them is a good answer. The definitive answer has already been given, but
well,
do your best.
What about, you know what, I think I got
you're full
something.
Of static electricity.
No, I sat in some candle wax with
oh,
my elbow.
Really?
What a party that was, huh?
Wow.
Because I was like this.
I see.
I also have a definitive answer. I said water and feed.
Well, that's good. Okay. Bite is the answer she's looking for.
Without sticking to a thing, just feed.
Feed, yeah. Bite is what she wants. You got some good answers so far, Marianne. Twice a day I have to.
I hate to be repetitive, but I said feed.
Feed is good. Gayla?
I have to talk to the animals. I'd say feed.
Feed is good, right.
The tree is a feed.
Ah, well, there it is. That means George wins the game. Come on down, George. you go. What is that? 12 turns. Gayla, what can I say? We've got some gifts for you. It was a pleasure to meet you, my dear.
Thank you.
Many thanks for being with us in Match Game 77. Gayla Lisitra. While we're spinning her off, we're going to spin these messages just for you. Then, here's your old friend, George Fredericks. George Fredericks has been up here 12 times. This is his 12th game. He's got $16,000 even. Here we go, George. We polled a recent studio audience and we got their best response to this. Blank on. O-N. Now remember, you get $500 if you match your most popular answer, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third. Call him out, George.
Richard.
Right on!
Right on! Charles. Chuck.
Try left on. Oh, what the chick said when I was out with her about two nights ago at a went to the Sportsman's Lodge. She said I was a I'll try to get it right. I was a turn on.
Well, you turned me on. I'll tell you that. I reckon I'm gonna get in there. And Brett. Brett.
What she really said. Go on.
Go on. Go on. Turn on and right on. Those are the three. You can choose one of those or one of your own.
I think I'll go with right on.
Right on. Okay. We are looking for right on. May we slide the $100 number. Put on. Put on. That's not a bad one, is it? Put on. Good one. Let's see if right on is under the $250 number. Turn on. That's Chuck's answer. Last chance for right on. Here we go.
Right on.
As you well know by this time, George, you're going to play for ten times the $500 or $5,000. And you have to match one celebrity exactly.
I'll try again with Richard.
Okay, here we go.
Last chance, Richard.
The team, they've done it before. Let's see if they can do it again. Worth $5,000? Press blank. That's P-R-E-S-S. Blank. Now, George, what answer do you want to give us? Would you think we'll match his in this instance? Press
conference.
Press conference. How would you say? Well, now, you know, I thought of that, too. Because of that previous business there, right on and all that, the first thing that came to my head was press on. So I couldn't think of anything else. Let's see what Richard says. He says press conference.
I said press room.
Press room. That was a tough one.
Press man.
They were all good. Press on, press conference, press room. Okay, press man. So you got $16,500 all together. You're going to meet another player. Here comes Phyllis Lear. Now, Phyllis, we want to find out a little bit about you before we begin here.
Okay, I'm from Van Nuys, California, and I have two teenagers and a Springer Spaniel dog, and I'm a secretary.
Well, aren't you cute? Doesn't she look too young to
be? She's a Marianne Mobley lookalike.
Yes, she does indeed.
Well, thank you very much for that.
Phyllis, we got to stop and do a little business with America, and then we'll get back to you and you. Watch this now. Here we go. Listen, we don't have time to ask you a question. I mean, in connection with the game. But we will next time we get together. Okay?
Okay.
All right. And is there anything anyone has to say before we leave here? We got a few seconds here. You have something to say? No.
No, thank you.
Haven't we got to watch the circus show tonight on CBS?
Yes,
is this tonight
Charlie...
the night?
Yes, the and then also in February, Charlie's Angels. Okay. I'm working with those Charlie's three beautiful Angels. Girls.
Oh, terrific. Wow. I wish
my
I
friend
could wear
David Doyle is on Charlie's Angels.
Yes,
splendid.
A nice man.
Listen, join us next time for Match Game 77. I'm Gene Rayburn. Goodbye.